A lot of organizations, so we want to five. We want to be the ones they love. They use the L word when they talk about us. And so what we need to focus on is value added. Hot dang, value added. How many times you heard value added? Well, let me tell you, folks, in a tough economic times, value added gets right pricey. When you think of, I'm going to take what the customer expects and add more, if you think about it linearly, pretty soon you run out of room. You know that hotel that says, you're such a great guest, we're going to upgrade you to the concierge level. I got to sell that room on the concierge level. You've been so good to us, I tell you, we're going to upgrade you to first class. I got to sell that seat in first class. So what I'm saying is, value added has a dead end looking at it. What I want to focus with you this morning is value unique. Because I think you've got unlimited opportunity when you think about how do we create a unique experience, value unique. I don't want my customers to go, wow. I want them to go, whoa, I didn't expect that. I want to take their breath away. And how does Disney do it? How does Disney do it? How does they manage it so you don't notice that way? What do? They entertain you, right? They put signs to say, if you stand here, the wait time's 20 minutes. Actually, it's 18. They underpromise and overdeliver, also known as Mickey Lies. They have those misters. They keep hiding the line. They move you around and move because they found that standing wait feels different than moving wait. They manage it. But here's the thing that's kind of cool about it. They also use the characters, don't they? And what character is most likely to be at Space Mountain, the most popular ride, except the new one that's just came out from Harry Potter. But what character would be likely to be at Space Mountain at the busiest time of the day? Which character? Goofy. Goofy. I have a niece who played one of the Goofies. There's three. Why Goofy? Why Goofy? Who's most likely to be scared standing at line? The children or the adults? The adults. Kids are saying, I want to get online. And they found adults relate more to Goofy. Folks, I'm just reporting. I'm not evaluating. I'm just reporting. What I'm saying is that they thought about stuff like that. They thought about how can we manage this? How do we look at it in a way that makes the experience? One, that how do we think about it through that customer's lens? How do we think about it through their customer's lens? One Friday, I flew home late one evening, and I called home from the airport, and my wife informed that a friend of ours was dying. He'd been suffering a four-year bout with cancer, and she said, it doesn't look good, and I don't think he's going to live through the weekend. And she said, would you mind, on your way home from the airport, stopping by the supermarket and picking up a large deli tray that we could take to the family over the weekend? As many of you know, we show our love and concern for people with what? I am loved. Anyway, I stopped by this supermarket, humongous supermarket. They had a deli section and a bakery and a florist. They're open late. They sold tires. It's a huge place. I went straight back to the deli counter. I told the woman over the counter, I said, I'd like to get a large deli tray. She said, I'm sorry, we're out of deli trays. I said, that's okay. I'll shop around the store and pick up a few things I know we're going to need and give you a chance to make up the deli tray. She said, no, the woman who makes deli trays has already gone home. I did not realize that was a specialized skill. She was probably at the deli tray makers convention in Las Vegas. That's where she was at. I said, well, I'm sure what my wife would want me to do in a situation like this is to get all the stuff for a deli tray so we can put it together. I said, how about giving me a half a pound of that ham slice then? She goes, she takes the ham out of the case, peels the plastic off, puts it in the slicer, wah, 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 puts it in a little bag, puts it up on the counter. She said, would that be all? I said, no. I'd like a half pound of that turkey slice then. So she takes the turkey out of the case, peels the plastic off, puts it in the slicer, wah, 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 puts it in a little bag, puts it up on the counter. She said, would that be all? I said, I'd like a half pound of that sweet. I could tell I was getting on her nerves. I'm thinking, I'm going to start asking for stuff hard to reach. Finally, I got about $30 worth of stuff laying up on that counter, and I look over behind her, And I said, how much would you charge me for one of those plastic trays that has a lid on it? She looked at me and she said, you can't buy a tray unless you buy a tray. I said, I beg your pardon? She said, you can't get a tray unless you get a tray. I'm thinking that must sound real smart to her. You know, I'm real close to going to the store manager and telling him, if you hired her to be rude, you need to give her a raise. They had those deli trays as a part of their inventory system. See, at the end of the day, they could count up the empty deli trays and see how many they sold. Like the picture show. You know, when you go down to the concession stand, you say, I'd just like to get a cup of ice. What do they say? Got to charge you for the cup. Same thing. What do you think the owner would want to do? I'm willing to buy the tray. But no, you can't get a tray unless you get a tray. I ended up stopping at a hardware store and I got my tray, but I got to think about how many times we go through these things that make sense in